In this video, I'm going to take you through editing your company profile. So up on your menu bar, go to Support and then Edit Company Information. Once on the screen, we can now enter in all of your company's details and information. So at the first box up here, we can add a logo. Now we can do this by just simply dragging and dropping an image into this space right here. I happen to have an image available from my desktop, so I can just drag and drop and it will be uploaded into this box. And then you can then start to enter in the rest of your company information. So for example, your company name. When you're first setting up the system, the local currency code field will be empty. So you need to actually put in or enter in your local currency code. Now mine is US dollars for my example, but I mean it could be Canadian dollars, British pounds, etc. And then you need to just carry on and fill in the rest of your information. So we can put in the branch address and then the city and the state or province. If you have a company email that you might want to put in here, and a phone number. So the formatting for your phone number will be applied from when you are actually entering in that format from your client preferences. So you can just simply enter in the numbers and hit the tab button, and the formatting will then be applied to that field. If you have a second phone number, you can enter that in here, and a fax number, also your website address, and then your time zone. So Seattle being Pacific Standard Time, we're going to enter in PST, but obviously that will be whatever time zone that you're on, you wouldn't want to put in there. And then we have the organization number. Now, if you're a money service business, you will want to put in your registration number here. But if you are in Sweden, this is actually a mandatory field, so you will actually need to put that registration number in or organization number in there. The client code and the client key. Now these are two numbers and key numbers that are obtained from ClearView Systems when you first register your software. And what that code and that key does is that enables the sanction list to be checked against your customers. So when you're adding in new customers and you want them to be checked against the sanction list, that is actually activated and able to do it. It also will affect your currency code. So the system will be able to update connecting to ewire.me, which is a multi-source server for obtaining accurate currency rates. Then when you come down to your branch ID, now if you're a multi-branch company and you want to distinguish the different branches within that company, you can enter in different codes. So for example, this can be your head office or your HO branch ID, and then you can apply different ones for different branches within your company. Now once you have all this information, you can then click Save Settings.